Anaconda, Mega Predator. Judged on weight alone, the South American Anaconda is the world's largest snake. The mere mention of its name brings images of an awesome and terrifying killer.
Look at the top. Oh, wow. The right edge, you see it?
Okay, you're one. You're fine.
A mass of writhing muscle. It is truly an icon of the Amazon. With a strike as fast as a boxer's jab, anacondas are a challenge for those who try to unravel their mysteries. Anacondas are mysterious creatures, fearsome as well as fascinating. A non-venomous constrictor, the anaconda is the most aquatic of all the boas. Their stealth, cunning, and size, combined with their limbless movement, enhances their scary mystique. But today, scientists are beginning to learn more about this cryptic creature.
Look at that, I wonder. It's not gonna be that easy to find a ghost today.
Almost two decades ago, when cryptologist Dr. Jesus Rivas was looking for a site for his anaconda research, Otto El Cedral seemed the perfect laboratory for his studies. Over the years, Jesus has made numerous trips to the Llanos to collect data on the anaconda. The open savanna doesn't make his work easy, but at least possible. He has become a familiar sight stalking through lagoons and muddy swamps, often accompanied by Victor Delgado, a resident of Otto El Cedral. They find a number of snakes in the mud trying to escape the intense heat. No females, only a lot of belligerent males.
You're not being had.
Welcome to the club. How'd you say that does not hurt as much as a tetanus shot?
That's right.
Definitely not.
That's exactly right.
So until you tell me, there's no snake catchers who get bitten once. Either zero times or 20.
What a temper.
They do find one lone female.
Oh my lord. Yeah, hold it down. This is an example of problems anacondas get. This is a very large girl, but she's very skinny. And the reason might be because she has a bad mouth infection. Horrible mouth infection. She's got a girl work. Oh, she's really capable. We've never seen a snake this before. She has infection below the teeth, in the lower jaw, and she has a piece of bone sticking out here. Seems that the mandible was broken in two, and one part is there. It's a solid, it's a bony structure there. And she might have had this wound for probably quite a long time. That's why she's so skinny. She's shedding, which is a good sign. They do that to recover from wounds and stuff. But she's fighting back, she's not giving up. I mean, she was in a very warm water, which is what they do about infections. They give themselves fever. She hasn't eaten in a long time, obviously. That's why she's so skinny. And this horrible mouth infection. She doesn't heal her mouth soon enough so she can stop eating. Then she probably won't make it. I have seen anacondas survive wounds as bad as this in the mouth. But she's not a goner. They are extremely tough animals and she might recover from this one. We'll just better let nature be.
The future for this snake is not good. If she swims away, the birds mock her. One of these birds would make a good meal, but with her injury and weakened condition, hunting would prove impossible for her. The search for a breeding female has resulted in finding a lot of snakes, but all of them male.
He's a boy, isn't he? Oh, thank you.
Anacondas have a temper and can be hard to handle. It certainly seems to be true of the males they find. In hopes that a male will lead them to a breeding ball, Jesus and Sarah have decided to insert several with transmitters. Inserting a battery-powered inert resin cartridge containing two AA batteries, the transmitter's enclosed antenna will allow Jesus and Sarah to track the males as they search for a female.
4646, well, that should be easy to remember. Let me hold the head so she's a little
bit. Weighing over 2.5 ounces and measuring about 6 inches, the transmitter will eventually pass unchanged through the snake, even with the anaconda's strong digestive juices.
Looks like it's a big meal, but this guy swallows a lot bigger things than this. It's not really anything too bad for him to do this. It goes down smoothly.
Radio telemetry is a tremendous aid for wildlife biologists, enabling them to track the most elusive wildlife in hostile environments.
It's going down nice and smoothly.
Because of the snake's unique anatomy, traditional external tracking devices like collars or tags don't work. The transmitter must be internal. The transmitter's small size will not trigger digestion, and because anacondas eat infrequently, it will stay in the snake for several weeks.
So now we have this guy wired. Go find some claws.
Anacondas like shallow water to form their mating balls. The large lagoon in El Cedral is too much water. Searching for drier conditions, Jesus, Sarah, and Victor travel to Pato El Frio, another ranch and wildlife preserve about 40 miles away. The environment there is much different. It's definitely drier, and their chances of finding a large female to implant improve greatly. After much searching and scaring of the humans, they find what they've spent days looking for.
It's a big one.
The snake is immense, probably well over 14 feet long, and very heavy.
Oh, hey, girl!
Amazing. I haven't been with Jesus catching this large an animal before. And the head is huge. It's a lot of fun.
And because she's so muscular, her muscles make it very difficult to push the faster, hard enough that I'm confident she will keep it.
After many long days filled with disappointments, finding a big female makes up for all the frustration. For field biologists, compiling data is like putting together pieces of a puzzle. And now this female will become one of those pieces. Predation as they travel in the open, searching for a receptive female. This is where their smaller size can be a plus. With each flick of their tongue, the males pick up the female's irresistible perfume. This perfume, called a pheromone, is a scent or odor produced by a female anaconda that lets the males know she's ready to mate. It's unclear if female anacondas only leave this scent as they crawl, or if males also pick up the scent from particles in the air. result. And so they constantly have to move to places that have the right temperature they need. They seek the heat when they need it, and they avoid it when it's too intense. The sight of an anaconda crossing a road or making its way across a pasture is not unusual. Most other wildlife simply ignore it, but not the birds. The appearance of an anaconda in the open is cause for a lot of squawking and screeching from the bird population. Referred to as mobbing, it's a common behavior when a potential threat is encountered. With the possibility of fledglings nearby, the birds take no chance with this intruder. The snakes have poor hearing, but they're quickly aware of the bird's presence and just try to leave the scene as soon as possible. The brief season between the end of the rains and the start of the dry season is vital for much of the wildlife. It's a time to feast, literally, before the famine that is to come. For this jabiru stork family, it's time to make sure its offspring is thriving. Nearby, a howler monkey family forages in trees that will soon be bare. Riverbanks, forest edges, and lagoons come to life with an extraordinary variety of wildlife. With more than 100 species of mammals and over 300 species of birds, trees virtually bloom as thousands come to roost in their branches. Shorelines host dozens of varieties of waterfowl, drawing tourists from all over the world and marveling at this visual feast. At first glance, the Llanos seems idyllic. Its pastoral serenity belies the daily struggle for survival, playing out with savage intensity between predator and prey. Of a rich and diversified wildlife habitat.
Oh my God, there you go.
Jesus's records on Venezuela's anacondas date back to the early 1990s. So recapturing and evaluating some of his subjects continues to shed light on the stability of the population.
I'm pretty sure he will be fine, but I don't want to add any more stress. Since 1992 to the present, I have marked 13 or 1400 anacondas.
Hearing the frenzied call of an anxious jacana is a sure tip-off that an anaconda is somewhere nearby. And this one's caught something. Finding one feeding gives Jesus and Sarah a rare opportunity to observe this behavior in the field.
Yeah, it has a meal. I don't know what it is yet, but let's go around so we don't disturb her. It seems to be a turtle. It's important for me to find out the whole range of prey items they consume. This is always a compromise that some biologists have to deal with. We need to learn as much as we can from the animals, but doing as little into interference with the normal behavior. Anacondas normally kill their prey by squeezing it so tight that the heart cannot fill up with blood, the heart cannot beat. That stops circulation of the animal and kills it very quickly. The anaconda doesn't have any good...
This highly sensitive organ is crucial for any snake to be able to navigate its world.
Right now, as she's tongue-flicking, what she's doing is picking up chemical signals.